We welcome you back to Fox 8 News in the Morning on this Tuesday. Breast cancer is being treated with more success than ever before. But some of the therapies that can cure cancer, such as radiation, can also come with a small risk of the survivor developing some heart complications later on, particularly in those with left-sided breast cancer. But this morning, we are joined by Dr. Chirag Shah, who's an oncologist with the Cleveland Clinic Hospitals, who has some very encouraging news about this new heart-sparing therapy. Thank you so much for being with us today.
Well,
we really appreciate it. So basically, you say that having left-side breast cancer isn't any more prevalent than right. It's just pretty much split evenly.
Yeah, absolutely. Left- and right-sided breast cancers occurred about the same rate, about 50-50. It's just with left breast cancers, we tend to see the issue of the heart sitting behind the left breast and chest.
Because of the position that it's at. So when you're doing radiation, unfortunately, then you're finding that years later, some of these women will end up with heart issues. On top of then going through, having gone through breast cancer and all that, with their family. So talk about how you guys came to be in finding out this new therapy, ABC, and exactly what it is. It's fascinating, and it's so easy and cheap.
Absolutely, and that's really the goal. So studies in the past published in New England Journal have shown higher rates of heart side effects in women with left breast cancers who received radiation in the past. So what we've done is use ABC, or active breathing control. Patients will wear a small breathing piece during treatment, and when they take a breath in, the chest and breast lifts up, the heart stays where it is, and we're able to target that with our computers and only turn the machine on when the heart is separated from the chest. And that allows a much reduction in heart dose, about 75% reduction in heart dose. And we also use some advanced laser imaging to make sure the patients are accurately set up each time. Mm-hmm. And we use computerized components inside the radiation machine to block out even the tip of the left ventricle to further reduce the heart dose.
So isn't that amazing?
It's pretty amazing. It's very efficient, and it really is a benefit to patients.
And talking to some patients too, they find that concentrating more when they're going through something as anxiety high going through radiation, but concentrating now on breathing and doing that is actually so much more beneficial and takes away from a lot of the anxiety of just having that done.
Absolutely.
So talk about now the promising results that you're seeing. You're not seeing as many of these negative side effects with women with the heart. I mean, it's hugely promising.
Absolutely. So we don't have, 10 or 20 year data yet, but the data we have that we've looked at so far shows about a 75% reduction in the heart dose. So in years past, the average heart dose was around 7 units. It's currently the standard is 4. At the Cleveland Clinic, our cases are routinely under 1 unit. So we took the 7, dropped it under 1, and with the current standard from 4 to less than 1. So more than a 75% reduction in heart dose. And a study from another institution showed that led to no difference in heart perfusion after radiation, which is the penultimate goal of treatment.
It's each week we're going to get into something more specific, but while we have you here, your opinion on self-exams and the importance of those for women.
I can't stress the role of self-exams and even mammograms enough. I think that I see patients day in and day out in my clinic who were diagnosed by self-exam, and I think that it's a pivotal part of routine, health maintenance and health care for women of all ages.
And sometimes just finding a lump doesn't mean it's cancer.
No,
so always
not at all.
To get it thoroughly looked at, and it might not be a lump because cancer can come in other different forms too, as in little dimples and all sorts of other things that just don't seem right to you, right?
And that, exactly. And what I tell patients and even people who ask me this question is, if something doesn't feel right, get it checked out, because it could just be a dimple, it could be a new source of pain, it could be a lump. If something doesn't feel right on your exam or in how you feel about your breasts, you should usually see a physician and get that looked at.
There was a little bit of a debate for a while saying that women did not have to get as many mammograms or routine mammograms every year. That's been going back and forth. What are your thoughts on that, and when is the magic age for you for women to get that baseline?
Sure. So I think obviously it's a continued area of controversy. And I tend to say, age 40 is a good baseline, unless you have a strong family history or other reason why. I tend to support the idea of starting at 40 and constantly evaluating based on the patient's history, mammogram findings, and we go from there.
Sure. Thank you so much.
Thank you for your
time. Incredible information on this new technique. Just really incredible. Dr. Shah, thank you.
Thank you.
With the Cleveland Clinic. All right.